friends and neighbors. It's me, Akiic to the Head. We are back. Farming Sim 15 on the old family farm. When we last left off, we had just felled this tree, and now we're going to load it up, fell a couple more, and take them over to the lumber mill for some much-needed cash. And if we just jump through here, you can see, whoop-a-la, we got Philip over here cultivating this field on field 7. As you can see, there he is. He's cultivating hard at work. And once we get a couple of these trees over to the lumber mill, then we're going to finish up that big plowing project over there around the fields 11, 12, and 13. We'll combine them, depending on how much problems we actually have here. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump in. Let's get started. Let's get this opened up. And we'll just lower this a little bit. Let me just get it in reverse. Now pull forward. Now, I try to cut them a little long. We'll see how it goes, see if it will fit in there with no problem. But we'll see how it goes. I may have to trim them a little bit. Bite it. There you go. Open it up a little bit. No, won't let me bite it. So let me open it all the way again. And lower it down. Let's try this again. Try it this way then. That seems to work the best. So let me put that in reverse. And let's go ahead and put it forward. Now hopefully I didn't cut this too long. It looks like I might have though. Yeah, so what I need to do, let me put this in reverse. And if I aim it just right, should be right there. Let's jump out. That should be good. Hate to cut this much off, but we're going to have to do that. There it is. Okay, let's go ahead and get back in. And if we tilt this over and open it up, there we go. Put it in reverse. Whoop, lift it up. There you go. Now, I'm going to have to pick up that little piece, unfortunately, but let's go ahead and get out of the trees so you can see. And we want to go forward a little bit and then close. There we go. And let's go ahead and de-limb that a little bit. Let me jump out here. There we go. There we go. Now let's see if I can do this without hitting anything. There we go. And then lift up. Now this definitely going to be too long as well, won't it? Yes it is. So what I want to do is let's go and load it from the opposite side. That way we can know, or we'll cut off the skinnier end, leave the fatter end on there, because it's, whoa, it's worth more money. So if we do this and put it in reverse a little bit. Okay, let me just take a look. That will fit in there, no problem. So we will cut off a little bit here. Should be okay right there. If we go back in, there we go, and we'll go pick up the last little piece up there as well as these two smaller pieces, and then we'll go ahead and get some more trees cut. go. Hopefully that will be short enough that we can load it in there. Looks like it might be a little long. Or not, maybe it will work. Perfect, okay. Let's leave that there. Let's go ahead and pick up the smaller pieces. And we'll cut down one, maybe two more trees. Then we'll get busy on plowing. So if we can tag that just right. That didn't work the way I intended it to work. So let's lift this up. Let's put it in reverse. Get on a little straighter. Here we go. And should this work? There we go. Let's go ahead and lift this up. Perfect. Now let's get in reverse. We'll grab one more piece. Then what we'll probably do is we'll probably cut that tree down and maybe that tree as well. I'm hung on the stump. There we go. Oh, don't hit the trailer. There we go. And put it in reverse a little bit. There we go. Now we are on hard, don't forget, so we might have, it probably be a little difficult to actually get any money out of this, so. No, don't you do that. It's not going to stay there, unfortunately. We'll worry about that later. Let's get this tree out down here. So if we cut this tree, let's see if we can fell it just right. Cut it right there. Hopefully it will fall the right way. We're gonna have to bump it. Okay. If we can bump it, have it fall the correct direction, then we'll be okay. So if we just bump it. No, you weren't supposed to fall that way. So let's get this delimbed. Like so. Okay, so if we want to, cut it about right here. And we'll cut it about right here. Then we'll cut it right here. That's probably going to be a little long, but we can make do with that. So if I put this back in forward, let me come around here. Let's open this up. this up. Perfect. Let's just put this in reverse and just kind of scoop that out. There we go. Perfect. Now go back and forward. Now we will have to get a stump grinder eventually to get rid of these stumps, and we also need a tree planter as well to plant some new trees eventually. And let's open this all the way up. And here we go. Perfect. Let's load this up from this direction so we don't have to back up or anything. There we go. And finally, we get this piece here. Lovely. Then we'll grab that one piece there. We'll load that on there. And then we'll head that to the lumber yard, and then we'll go do some plowing. So if we come into here, and let me just scoop this up. Now I'll definitely have to cut some of this off, which is no problem. Okay, now let's just put that out like that. And can I get up here? Yes. And then we will cut. There we go, cut right there. And let's open this up. Whoop, wrong way. Perfect. Let's just kind of wiggle these around, straighten them up. There we go. Now let's go ahead and take this back to the lumber yard. Let's close this up, put this down. I'll take care of that other piece off camera. I'm not worried too much about that. Let's see how much we get for this now from the lumber yard. That's two trees there, so it shouldn't be too bad. I'm thinking maybe 10 grand or so. I'm hoping it's more than that, but we are on hard. I'm not sure exactly on hard how much we're going to get. Whoop, 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 whoop. And then hopefully we'll be making enough money to where we'll be able to get a wood chipper soon, and that's where our money will probably be the best. We just put a wood chipper out there at the forest area, and we just chop the trees up into the wood chipper as we go along and bring the wood chips up to the heating plant. Okay, and we want to turn up in here. Let's see how much we're actually going to get for this. Oh, this tractor don't want to make it up. Don't stop on me. It's going to stop. Okay, so we're going to have to back up a little bit. Oh, careful. Let's see if I can just come around at an angle. There we go. Well, this thing ain't got the power for it. So we're at just shy of 4,000. We're at 3,700. Wow, made more than I thought it was going to do on hard. So that's good. So we know what we can do here. So let's go ahead and we'll just leave this here for right now. Let's go ahead and put the emergency brake on. We'll cut that off. Let's see how he's doing. He's almost finished. But what we want to do is, let's leave that trailer here. Let's go down and pick up the cedar. Hopefully this one will handle the cedar. We'll get the cedar going on this one. And then we will plow the field with the other one. Let's go ahead and go a little bit in cab. There we go. So if this one will handle the cedar, that would be great, because then we can plow these fields together or join these fields together and get our crops growing for sure. Now give us three large fields and a couple small fields, which will be lovely. Now, do we have a spot on here where we can put a weight on here? We do. So if I come over here, let me just put this here for right now. Like that. Let's pick up a weight. I thought I had another weight. Maybe it's inside. It's back there. So we'll pick up a weight. And we'll grab the cedar next. And then hopefully this thing will be strong enough to be able to load the cedar. Carry the cedar around. And we said we're going to go wheat first, so let's go wheat first. Yep. And yeah, it seems to be able to handle this fairly decent. It's a little heavy. I can feel the front end a little light. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have them go around in a circle to begin with first to put a headland on. Whoa, it don't want to stop. Let's put this in reverse. There we go. Now we're going to have them go in auto. We're going to have them go in a circle. This will give them a headland to begin with. So let's have them do that. We'll shut that off. We'll jump out. Not sure why he done that, but hey, more power to him. So we'll have them go around in circles a few times. Let's jump over here and see how he's doing. How are we doing on time? Almost 19 minutes in, so we'll let him finish this up. Two more passes and Philip should be okay with this. Let's just get rid of Philip for a minute. Let's do this ourselves. And let me turn on the GPS. Like so. Let's lift this up. And I want to control 3. That should. Like that. Now. There we go. And he's going at an angle. How about that? That's some smart driving there. And we're missing a little bit, because it's not detecting the actual width of the device. I see that. Or maybe it is. It's a little off. Let me just back up for a minute and grab this other piece on this side. How far back do we gotta go? Not too far. How's he doing over there? He's about to make his first pass through. Well, this thing has a hard time actually getting the power to go. and it pulls really bad. Go. And then we want to come back in here, put it in reverse. Okay, and how's he doing? He's almost got one headland. We'll do let him go one more time around, and then we'll go grab the plow. And of course you're going to miss that. Why not? Gives me more work to do. Sure, I enjoy that. Okay, put it in reverse. Grab this last little bit. And away we go. Then what we'll do is we'll leave the cultivator right across the road over here at the other field. Go grab the plow, and we should be in good shape then. Okay, let's go drop the cultivator off. Another field's cultivated. Okay, we'll go grab the plow. Now we will need to, this is the right direction that we want it on, because remember we discussed this last episode, how we would do this, and let me just come around, get wide on it, and come right through here, and let me just do, let's change the direction, like so. I want to control 3, detect the width, there we go. And that should be good. We want to allow fields on, set it down, lock in place, and away we go. Now remember, we're going to go all the way down. And join all 3 fields together. Just like this. We'll come down to the corner, then we'll angle it slightly to go around that tree. About right here. Like so. We'll lift this up. Put it in reverse. And now let me go at an angle. Get out of the trees, Michael. Get out of the trees. So now if we do the control enter, that gives us our angle. So that means we want we'll go right to there. So if we let this down about right there, and then we want to come over, I'd say about right there. Lift this up. Control enter again. Just like this. This will give us our outside edge of where we want. Remember, we're going to shorten the fields up a little bit on the back side over there by the road. But this is, should be good enough right here. Like this. Lift that up. And what we'll do is let's just get into place here and we'll just cut this edge off so we know we're straight. Let me put that in like that. There we go. Oh, the tree. That's the one I want right there. So if I line it up as such, set this down, lock into place, and away we go. Let's just quickly check this guy. Let's fire him for a minute. Let's just level this off slightly, or straighten it up slightly. Like so. Okay. Now if we go 5, we want off of auto. This is fine. So go. Close that. Back over to here. Lift up. Now did it shut off? Limit the fields. Okay. So let's put this back in reverse. And then we want to go this way. So let me get in reverse again. And lower this, lock into place, and away we go. Now this will give us our dimensions on all three fields. Lovely. So I hope you guys are all doing good. I know I'm doing good. My vacation's about, I'd say about half over now. It's the 17th of December. I got until 2nd of January. So, okay, we want to end about right here, I think it was. Let's lift this up. Let's get at an angle slightly so I can see exactly where the angle's got to be. And if we do that, perfect. And I want to hit about right there because we want to cut it off a little bit down at the end so we have a little room to turn around. So if I come up to right there, that'd be perfect. And VW3, like so. Lift this up, and then we will cut right here. Perfect. There we go. And then this end down here that I'm cutting off, that will be made back into bare dirt or grass rather, and we'll cut that off, and then that way we'll have room to turn around and not worry about the road and everything. Now technically we could have left it there because we don't have no clipping or anything like that, so we could have left it there, but it's okay. So that's going to be our dimensions of the field. That gives us a nice clean 3 fields and we'll be good to go. So let me just throw this back into up and down mode. Put it in reverse, like so. Lower this down, lock into place, and away we go. So what do you guys think? Is this a good idea to do the 3 fields like this? I think so. That way we don't have so many small fields that we can take care of. We just got, you know, 3 large ones we can take care of. And then a couple of small ones. And this will help us out on our harvest and stuff. We won't have so much to do at one time. And it should do us should do us good, I think. So we'll spin that plow back around. We'll come back this way now. Lower this down, lock into place, and away we go. Now there's a couple areas in there I'll have to re-hit, but that's not a problem. Now we can't put the hired help on this. Unfortunately, they don't plow the fields on their own, so we'll have to do this ourselves. And lift up. Spin the plow around. Just like that. How's he doing over there? He should be getting close to being finished, and we can fertilize it. How are we doing on time? 31 minutes in, so we're definitely going to have to be wrapping this up. So I'll make this one last pass. Like so. Let me just put it in reverse. Let me just hit this couple little areas right here. Like so. And what I'll do is come down and I'll just grab these two areas, and then the rest of this I'll definitely finish off camera so you won't have to deal with it. Like so. And it looked like there was an area here I missed. How I missed this, I'm not sure. There we go. And final piece right over here. Perfect. Now, I'll put the brake on. We'll come back to that shortly. And we'll look here. So I'll leave it there, everyone. We've got two trees felled and taken to the lumberyard. It gave us quite a bit of money. We've got this field almost completely fertilized. We got this field seeded. We've got this field cultivated. And then we got our makings of our three fields being plowed together and joined over there. So mash that like up button, show me the love. It only takes a few seconds. It really does help me out. I can't express how much it does help me out, and it also helps others find the videos as well. Leave your comments and suggestions below. I do get to them all. I do enjoy interacting with everyone. Make sure you join the Steam group. That's the best way to find out what's going on events-wise, and you can join in on the discussions. Leave your comments straight there for everybody can see. There's currently, I believe, about 25, maybe 30 people in the Steam group. So there's always something going on, and be sure to follow me on social media. I'm Akiic to the Head. This has been Old Family Farm for Farming Sim 2015. Wave bye to Alan. We'll see y'all later. Bye-bye.